So now in this video, let's start tackling the second way of combining data when it is coming from different sheets or different files or in general different data sources. So just taking a look at what we have covered so far. In video 4, we started discussing the concept of union, and we covered that in detail over a number of videos, about 5 videos. Joins is going to be another such topic where we want to basically take a number of examples, because union and join are the two very common operations that a data analyst would be doing in Tableau in the course of preparing the data for analysis. And union is the simpler case, join is going to be a little bit more difficult. Now let's take a look at what was the image that we associated with union. If you remember, I said we copy and paste the data from another sheet and paste it at the bottom. Really, our current data was at the top and the new data got added at the bottom. That's the image I wanted you to associate with union. When it comes to join, the image is visualize copying and pasting columns to the right hand side. So in the union, our data stayed at the top, we copied pasted at the bottom. Here our data stays at the left, and then we are adding columns to the right. There we were adding rows, here we are adding columns. That's all in terms of simplicity. Just to give you a real image. So here is our employee master, and here is the department information where there is a head information for each department. So when we were pasting rows, the columns were identical, right? So we were able to just paste, our job is done. When we are pasting columns, now we can see the rows are not really identical. In the employee master, we have 20 records, whereas in the department, we have only 5, one each for each department. So our job really is, so here I have to take this department name and get the Christine Dean, and wherever sales occurring, here, I have to put Christine Dean. And the same, next billing, I have to find the head for billing, and then I have to populate. So basically my job is taking the department column value in each of the rows in the left hand side, searching for that on the right hand side, finding the column that we really want, and then bringing it here, right, row by row. So we are matching, and then we are bringing all the extra columns that we want and then populating it row by row. That's how the join actually is done by the database itself. So while I'm giving this might seem this is too simplistic and why I'm even mentioning this, but always come back and remember this when we are dealing with very complex join cases. And this example hopefully will steer you through a lot of complexities, because join is where there is often a lot of complexity, and I see both newcomers as well as very experienced people making mistakes. Let's see a simple example for this video and close. So here is the starting point. So I have the employee master. So this time our objective is actually to report develop a report like this. So for each department head, I want to list the number of employees who work under them. That's our objective. So let's go to Tableau. So employee master is already here. So department master. So just double click on the department master, and then as visually it is added to the right, to the side, right? Exactly like the image that I was telling you. So here our original data is on the left and something is got added to the right. We have this fancy circle to indicate something. So as of now, we can just leave it as it is. Let's look at the preview to see whether actually it makes sense. Yeah. So if you focus here, the data that came from this second file got added to the front. The head column is there. Since the department column occurs in both the left side as well as right side sheet, it is indicating this department is coming from the department master, which is the right hand side thing, right? So it has tried to do the matching and it did its job. Yeah, that's all it is done by default, right? So what do we really need to tell? How does Tableau really figured out how we want to match? That is what we do this in this called join configuration dialog. So we need to tell Tableau two things. The first question is how should the basically search be done, the matching, right? So which column name to take a match? By default, Tableau will take the column which has the same name on both data sources. So since we had a department on both sides, it automatically picked it up and it did the job. So we could have more than one column. That's also acceptable. We could do that. And then the second question is, what is the type of join we want to do? For default, it is selecting inner join. And it gives you a description of what it means. For now, as a beginner, especially in this video, let's keep the default because it more or less gives us what we want. Yeah. So the only thing that we have to do is just take a look at this and confirm everything is fine. So now let's go to the report and then look at this thing. So whenever you have a join data, like another sheet coming from through the join, it would be listed like this as a separate sheet itself. And then the columns which are coming here. So we want the head names here. And then we want basically number of employees who are reporting under this. Let's add a quick total record. So that's 20 records. So is this number right? How do we know? So let's add department and see whether it. So Catherine Morrison has actually two departments under her. So that led to basically this 4 plus 5, 9, 20. So this is good. So basically department head. So that's all in terms of, so we got the report we wanted. So in the next case, so let's handle a few more complexities of joins.